what are the operatory room disinfection procedures that should be observed, and are they any different than what we have already always been doing? And if so, why? Following the appropriate standard precautions, environmental infection control, including cleaning and disinfecting using an FDA-cleared and an EPA-registered hospital disinfectant. And again, as Eve said, that has the label on the label for coronavirus. Keeping in mind the coronavirus that was tested for the registration of that specific disinfectant is not necessarily the virus responsible for COVID-19. You can also use barriers, especially on surfaces that can't be adequately cleaned, such as knobs, switches, hoses, and connections. And in those cases, those barriers would need to be changed between each patient. In terms of anything different for COVID-19, the area would still be cleaned and disinfected in that same manner. Eve, would you like to add any additional information?
Sure, Kathy. I think that this is just an excellent opportunity to remind people that different disinfectants have different directions for use, and you need to read the label on whatever product you're using and follow those manufacturer's instructions. For instance, some disinfectants say you need to pre-clean the surfaces that are heavily soiled and then apply disinfectant and allow it to remain wet for a prescribed amount of time. Others require that you clean every time before you disinfect, and some are considered single step. So whatever you are using, make sure that you're using it according to what the label directions indicate.
And I will also add a question that actually came to me this morning. Someone asked the question, if I'm using wipes, should I also repeat using a spray disinfectant? And there's no indication in doing that you would adequately clean and disinfect with one specific disinfectant.
As long as it has a cleaning agent in it.
Yes,